This is Norton. A long time ago, when he was 12, he didn't know what to do with himself. He couldn't see the point of needing to learn, and he'd just waste his adult life in a small city firm. Until, that is, a Tollbooth appeared in his room and showed him how wrong he was to assume that life was dull. On an adventure quite wild, he saved rhyme and reason while still a child and restored them to the kingdom of wisdom. Or perhaps saved himself from becoming a component of the demons of ignorance, indulgence and indolence. He had danced with wit. He discovered a lot, but then he grew old, and now he's forgot. Between leisure and vice, he can hardly discern, as he wastes his time in his small city firm. Kills time in his free time, as he feeds his depression, with no watchdog to guard against this regression. He doesn't talk about his adventures anymore. What rubbish, he sneers, it's all just a big metaphor. Look how he wanders from places to places, knowing nothing but the trim on his own shoelaces. He makes his way up 62 floors to his attic. He lives with his bed and his I do it all-o-matic. It took his coat, his time, and his dictation of a report on the declining standards of the nation, ironed his shirt, administered drugs and other glutton, and then he accidentally pressed the wrong button. Don't be alarmed.
Who are you?
Don't you remember me, old friend?
Why, Tock, is that you? Tock the watchdog? What is this stuff?
Time has moved, Milo. I've been upgraded to a sleeker model. We haven't got any to spare. Now hurry, we must get back to wisdom to restore peace and harmony. Rhyme and reason are dead. The new demons, the ever-hungry power and the manipulative wealth have taken control. Chaos, poverty and violence now roam the streets unchallenged, thanks to Care Not, Bother Not and Do Not. I need to bring you back to fight, or they will break through the fourth wall and spill into your world. Now hurry, I'll scan you in.
The wonders of the human brain when addled. I'm talking to a literary joke who wants to scan me through a circuit board. You talk of metaphorical chaos, such as that caused in the mind by too much drink. I expect to fall into an inexplicably deep and dehydrated coma, and when I wake, your presence will be replaced by a splitting headache, a foul smell and double vision. Not the breakout of demons into the capital. Besides, you don't even tick anymore.
Evidently, neither do you. Think, Milo. Once again, save yourself and everyone else. We're losing signal. I haven't got long.
Ha! I don't believe you. Since you are a figment of my imagination, I don't believe myself.
It appears we're too late. You've been blind, Milo. Dr. Discord and the Din arrived a long time ago, and the rest have seeped through the cracks.
I've never seen the Din, and I go out every day.
You're right. You can't see a Din, and you can't see the figure of speech either. She's been stark thin beyond visibility. Now. unreal city. Under the brown fog of a winter dawn, a cloud flowed over London Bridge. So many. I had not thought death had undone so many.